This year's International Women's Day theme is Choose to Challenge. And that's exactly what our first guest, Jamie McMillan, has been doing since she and Pat Williams began promoting skilled trades for women back in 2015 through their organization, Kickass Careers. Welcome, Jamie. And I got to tell you, I love being able to say kickass on television. It's the first time I've ever been able to.
Oh, that's awesome. It was named by high school students, so.
So that's how you came up with the name?
Yes, absolutely. And it was 2014. I was in Fenelon Falls out of high school and looking for a brand to go under, and they came up with the brand idea for Kickass Careers.
Well, it catches the attention, especially of young people, correct?
Absolutely, absolutely. When they say Kickass is here to do a presentation, the kids are intrigued and it's engaging, so.
You've been an iron worker, you're now a boiler maker as well. You're involved in the trades for how many years?
I joined the trades in 2002. I became an ironworker journeyman not long after, and then I started a boilermaker apprenticeship around 2015, I believe. So I'm still working on that apprenticeship. I'm not certified yet. It's been a long road.
As a young lady, what influenced you to head for the trades as your career choice?
There's a long story and then the short story, so I'll give you the quick one. It's basically I didn't know about these careers while I was in high school, and I took a few convoluted pathways trying to find myself, and it wasn't until I moved to Hamilton in 2002 that I ran into a high school classmate from Timmins, Ontario in a chance meeting, and she was an iron worker and she suggested it to me, and I was looking for something and I had no interest in post-secondary, and it just changed my entire life. I got into an apprenticeship and it's just been an amazing experience ever since.
Was there a moment when you discussed it with her where you thought, well, I don't know if I can do that?
No, it was, even in our discussion, we only spoke on the side of the road where we had run into each other for maybe 15 minutes, but she had described what she was doing and I'd never heard of an ironworker. And she basically was like, oh, well, they built like the CN Tower and condos and all this kind of stuff. And it just sounded intriguing to me. I never really asked her much about it. I ended up doing research on my own. And honestly, when I applied for the position, I had no idea what I was getting into. I didn't like understand the full concept of it until I actually got on the job and started learning while I was earning.
In those early days, did you experience sexism on the job?
There's been challenges, and I've been the only girl on a job site with 400 men, and you're gonna have your, you know, you're gonna have your naysayers, you're gonna have your supportive men, but in overall, I mean, if you have a thick skin, a good sense of humor, great work ethic, and you go to work to do your job every day, you will end up having more fans than not fans, and you end up doing fairly well.
Move forward to, you know, 2014, 2015, when Kickass Careers got going, what prompted you to start promoting the trades, especially for young women?
Okay, so this goes back to 2007. So I was in the trade and there was very few women, especially as iron workers. And there's an organization called Skills Ontario. And somehow, through some way, they ended up finding my email address and sent me a message and asked me to start doing young women's conferences. So basically, they would have these events where young women would come and do a mentorship dinner or a lunch during the day, like a luncheon in a school, and they would just ask me to go as a mentor. And I started as a mentor at a table, and then one day a panelist speaker didn't show up, so I got asked to jump on a panel. And then somebody in the audience heard it, and they were like, oh, you should come and do a keynote. And then it just took off from there. Never expected to be to this level that I am today.
What kind of response do you get from the young ladies at these events?
So a lot of the young ladies don't understand about construction. They're not told about it. They're not told that these are careers that are genderless. It doesn't matter if you're male, female. If you could do the job, you could do the job. And so when they see that there's a female up there talking about being an iron worker, it's one of the top 10 most dangerous jobs in the world, and I do it, and I work with the guys, and I can do it safely, and I can do it just as well, and sometimes even better, the girls are like, they're empowered by that because they're seeing another woman doing it. And I get so many girls that come up to me after a presentations and they're so intrigued and inspired. They end up following me on social media. I become a mentor to them. And I've seen through the years, a lot of them end up getting into skilled trades because they were motivated by my message. And some of them are part of the Kickass team now.
That's fantastic. Yeah. I noticed on your Kickass website that you do have some males who are also mentors. How has that been working out?
Well, it's amazing. So through Kickass Careers, we don't just promote women in trades, we promote youth in trades. We're very specific on how we want to promote it. We want everybody to know that this is a job that everybody can do if you have the passion and drive to succeed in this industry. So we stay away from just the women thing. So having the boys and the girls both come to the presentations and seeing the men and women that are representing and that we could all get along and work in the same workplace, it actually is a really powerful message to give to the students, and we're trying to just make it normal so that nobody's saying it's boys versus girls. No, it's just normal for us to all work together.
And that really is the definition of equality.
Absolutely.
Right now is a fantastic time for young people to consider the trades.
Yes. Oh, for sure. So good. Right now, there's such a huge shortage in the skilled trades industry, and it's great because we have a really supportive government, both federally and provincially. The committees that the government are putting together, I'm actually on the Federal Advisory Committee for Skilled Trades, and it's awesome because they want to bring these to everyone's attention and prove that skilled trades are a first choice pathway.
Why do you think we've lost our way for so many years with youth choosing skilled trades as a possible career choice?
I don't know why they at some point decided to stop funding programs like skilled trades, technology classes in schools, but I mean, they started to change and the world became modern and everybody was jumping into IT and they somehow forgot about skilled trades. And now we have this huge gap in the industry with no one to build and maintain our infrastructure. So prices are going up if you want a plumber or an electrician. And so now they're realizing that with our failing infrastructure, man, we need skilled trades professionals. So they have to bring it back into the schools and start educating at an early age to change the mindset that they've created by making it sound like it wasn't really an important job.
During COVID-19 and this pandemic, how have you been spreading your message without being able to appear at events?
It was very challenging in the beginning, but thank goodness for the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program and Skills Ontario, because I'm partnered with both of them, and they have gone over and above to maintain their partnership with me. And so I've gone from doing presentations in person to very engaging online presentations that I've developed with the support and mentorship actually of the youth. I get the youth to tell me how to make my presentation better, and they have helped me, and it's become quite successful. I'm doing it every day.
Jamie, thank you so much for joining us, and keep on doing what you're doing to promote skilled trades for young people.
Thank you so much. I'm going to keep kicking ass.